These are all formatting. So now what we are into is subtotal and subgroup. That's where we want to learn now. For subgroup, what I'll do is I'll just say A, B, C, D, E, F, G. I call this as one. This is what I'm going to group as. I'm going to group this guy as, say, X, 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 Y, 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 Z. So, H. I can also do drag and drop that sequencing. I can also do that. Right? So, A, B, C, D, E, I just group it. A, B, C, D, E, A, B, C, D, E, he has now made it. So XYZ, XYZ, I just copy. Let me have only two groups. So let me have only two groups. So X, Y, X. I have it, let me have it like this. So 1000, 1000, 1000, 2000, 200. 200, 300, 400, 500, 5, 0, 8, 188, some values I'm just giving. I'm not particular on any value. I'm just giving some value here. What I like to do is all X, I like to group and then total it up. All X, I like to group and then do a subtotal. So this is what I like to do. In the same way, I like to group all Y. I like to total all the X value and total all the Y value. First thing that we need to do is column sorting. Let me have a row name. I'll say here name. Say group value. Assume that I have this here. So first we need to, whenever we like to do a grouping, the first thing that we need to do is the sorting. So I like to sort here. First is sorting. I sort. So whenever I would like to sort, go to data, sort. So click on sort. I like to sort by group. If I want the name also to be sorted, that is an additional sorting name. First, this is mandatory. So sorting has to happen before you apply a group. Then you go to subtotal. You can see there is a subtotal to the right. I have selected that now. Select the subtotal. It will ask you for what you want to do a subtotal. I like to do subtotal for group. For every change in group, I like to sum the value. What are all additional operations I can do? I can do count, I can do average, maximum, minimum. I like to sum all the values that is belongs to X, all the values that belongs to Y. I like to sum up and then show it. For that, first sorting is important and then I do a subgroup. Now you can see here, first level grand total, what is the value? Then X total 4083, Y total 2265, breakup of this, all values A, B, C, D, E. So these are all the values. Y total A, B, D and E. There is no C in the Y value. So I am able to get the subtotal and then I pass the value over here. So this is possible. I undo this. I'll redo it. So I undo all. I have done. So now I like to group it by. I am repeating it again. I like to just group it by name. I remove this. So I delete this. Let it be with the name. So please note the difference. Now it is sorted by name. I like to total based on name. I need to sum based on name. A how much, B how much, C how much, D how much, E how much. I like to sum based on name. For that, I sorted the data using name, group, subtotal. I'm just subtotaling it up. Click on subtotal. Instead of group, I select now name. Name, subtotal, value. So now you can see A, all A are subtotaled here. All B are subtotaled here. Very, very useful formula. This is the way subtotal formula is applied. You cannot change this 9. 9 has to be there. Right? I can type it as well, but 9 has to be there. So he introduces this row as soon as he did the subtotal. So he has done the subtotal now based on the range. Right? So A, B, C, D. I undo this now. I like to copy this into another sheet. The entire data, I like to copy it into another sheet just to show you the importance of while sorting in subtotal. If I like to do the subtotal, I click on subtotal. If I like to do the subtotal with group, see what happens. When I click on subtotal group, okay, you can see now subtotal X is repeated in multiple location because you have not sorted this. Right? The sorting is very, very important if you want to make the subtotal. This is wrong. Wrong grouping due to wrong subtotal based on grouping because of wrong subtotal based on grouping because of improper start. Right? So here somebody asked, can you tell me why this subtotal, this 9 is untouched? This 9 is a system command. He has introduced the 9, so you cannot change that 9. You can see everywhere that 9 is there. Right? Only range varies. Because that 9 is a system command for which indicates that it is a subtotal. Right? And it is introduced by the system. So the 9 is important, you are not supposed to change it. So wrong subtotal based on grouping because of improper sorting on group. Sorting on group, right? So I go back to the previous sheet. So if I have to do the subtotal based on group, first sort. Instead of name, you need to sort it by group. Once you sort it by group, you click on OK. Now you can see the group is sorted, X and Y. Click on subtotal. Click on subtotal. You get a subtotal window. Choose the group as you are at each change in group. That means all X will be grouped now. And then value needs to be subtotaled. I don't want to subtotal the name. Value needs to be subtotaled. And then I say OK. So this is now subtotaling based on value. Alright. So tomorrow we will be seeing some important topics like pivoting the table. And then conditional statements. If condition, if I want to do subtotaling if only the value is B, like that. So I need to manage subtotaling based on particular formula, particular condition. I can do that as well. Right? And some people are asking how to set a password. We'll come to that as we go. That's very simple. So we'll come to that as well, right? So today what we have seen, formula, extension of formula, managing multiple sheets, how to apply a formula from one sheet to another sheet. We have not touched links, etc. Excel, Visual Basic, do you cover? Yeah, we will cover it in last two sessions or so, right? We also cover it from macros. So macros also will be part of this, and also we'll be covering on advanced Excel, using how to open the Excel in a VB scripting, right? So we'll cover that as well. Yes, this session is recorded. As soon as we finish the session, I'll try to upload it by today itself, both the session. Tomorrow you should be getting the link, in case if you have not received the link today, right? So I end the session today with this. We are interested in percentage when we have. What is that in percentage? Can you just explain me? We are interested in percentage when we'll have. Can you just explain that? What do you mean by that? Where can we get? If so, we can get recording. You get it in the SOTA, openmentor.net. You need to register. So I'll just look into why it is not working. It is currently, the website is down. So I'll just look into why it is. So it will be up shortly. So I'll inform our people. Right, so you have to get through Open Mentor only. You will get the links. You have to register in Open Mentor, then only you can access. Currently the site is down, so I'll just check again whether it is working or not. So I'll just check. If it is not working, I will ensure that we'll make it up, in case if it is not working. So in this site, you need to register here. So please register to this site. I think it is working now. Please register to this site. Once you register it, you go to your course content. Automatically, once you log in with your user ID, you will get into your course pages. There it will be available, right? You will get using this email ID, you download SOTA from here. So you can see a SOTA training tool. You download this SOTA here, right? Once you download the SOTA, it will install it in your machine. Install it in your machine. From there, using this login, you log in. Once you log in, you'll get that content in your site. I'll try to show you how to log in through SOTA through my login ID. So I'll just open the SOTA over in my desktop. So you can see a SOTA over here in my desktop. So I'm just double click on that SOTA. You will get a login. It will ask you to log in. Yeah, it will ask you to log in. I just have to, you can see that login screen. I have to log in using your registration. You can register using your email ID. Right, I'm logging inside. This is the software you get. Once you submit over here, it will try to get into a page where you can see all the recorded session, right? So this is the place where I can get the recorded session. So I think it is in advanced Excel. It is already loaded. So you can see advanced Excel over here, day one class. So this is the place where you can view the recorded session. For security reasons, we have this flow. You need to go through this flow to access this So I only uploaded day 1, day 2 and day 3 I will upload it at the earliest. So this is how you need to download the SOTA tool into your local machine. So that's very important. Fine. So thanks. Thanks a lot. So have a nice day. So we'll meet tomorrow at 4 o'clock. Thanks. Bye.